The topic that is graphs. So what is exactly the definition of the graph here? So the meaning of the graphs. I am drawing the graph here. A, B, C, D. Here you can see that A, B, C, D are the vertices. And we also studied the same graph in the previous. A, B, C, D. We have already seen this graph in a previous explanation of the digraph. Here you can see the graph here. Here vertices will be mentioned with the same and edges also same. But original directed graph means this graph is not exactly to this because here the edges all are undirected. Means there is no direction between the vertices which joins the edge. There is no direction to the edge here. But here the direction will be given for the edges. A to B, A to C, C to D. But this is not like this. But this is not a like that. So we call these type of the graphs which does not have any directions. Directions will not be given here. So such a graphs will be called undirected graphs. Undirected graphs. In these kinds of the graphs also, a V is a non-empty set. V is also a non-empty set here. And the edge set will also be have an a set of unordered pairs of vertices. Unordered pair of vertices. Suppose AB is an edge, we can also write it. Similarly, ordered pair can be written like this. A comma B or also we can write it as AB. But unordered pairs of sets can be written like this. Like this, A comma B is equal to B comma A. Both are nothing but the same here. But in this cases, so that in these kinds of the edges, we not say like that AB is equal to BA because there is a direction only from A to B. But here there is no direction. So that we can also call the edge AB is nothing but an edge BA, both are nothing but the same. So that's why ordered pairs A comma B is nothing but a B comma A. We can mention any notation for the edge here. So that's why here the undirected graph is referred to as a simply graph also. So that's why these undirected graphs are called simply graphs. So we gave the definition. A graph is a pair V comma E, where V is a non-empty set of vertices. Of the vertices, and E is a set of unordered pairs of elements, which are taken from the set V, So here the graph, in this graph, V is called the vertices set of the vertices, that is called a vertex set. V is called the vertex set, and the elements will be called the vertices. And E is called the edge set. Elements of the E will be called undirected edges. Or simply called a edges also. And the elements of the vertex will be called the vertices. A set of vertices is called the vertex set. A set of undirected edges or simply edges is called the edge set. So here simply a graph is equal to G equal to V comma E. And we can denote it as G equal to V comma E. And also we can represent G equal to G of V comma E. So consider an, as according to this example, V equal to A, B, C, D and E equal to A, B, You can also write a BA also. AB, AC, CD. You can also write it as AB, AC, CD. That is your edge set. So here one thing is clear here. According to the definition of the graph, EV is a non-empty set. Means there is a non-empty condition is only for the V. That condition is not applied to E. E may be a empty set here. E may be a empty set. But V should not be empty. According to this, we can draw the graph also like this. Simply A, B, C. There is no edges between the vertices. Because there is no condition for the E. E may be a empty here. But condition is only for the V. V should not be non-empty. Non-empty means there is at least one vertex in the graph. Clear it is? If there is no edges in between the vertices, then it is called null graph. Then it is called a null graph. A graph is a also called a null graph. A graph is called a null graph if there is no edges between the vertices. So a graph with no edges. A graph containing no edges. Containing no edges. Containing no edges is called null graph. It's called null graph. Suppose a null graph contains simply one vertex. Suppose a null graph with a one vertex. With a one vertex is called trivial graph. Is called trivial graph. For example, like this. For the example of the null edges, this is maybe an example for the null graph. This will be the example for the null graph. There is no edges. For the null graph with only a one vertex is called the trivial graph. Trivial graph means there is only a one vertex. That is called a trivial graph. Here, the diagram, when we draw the graph of the, when we draw the diagram for the graph, we can join the edges like A and B. We can join the edges by the straight line or we can join the edges by the curve. The curve may be short or may be a long like this. We can join the edges either by the straight line or by the curve. Curve may be a short or long. Here the diagram can be drawn in more than one way. For one diagram can be drawn for the More than one diagram can be drawn for the same graph. For example, see here, suppose A, B, C, D are the vertices A, B, B, C, A, C, A, D, A, B, B, C, A, C, A, D, B, C, C, D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So number of 5 edges will be there here. So I am draw the graph for these. First I will take A. I will take a 4 points A, B, C, D here. First I join AB either by the curve or by the straight line. AB. And we also draw the BC also. And AC. AD, CD. This is one kind of the diagram. For the same number of vertices, for the same edges, we can draw the diagram also like this. A, B, C, D. AB, AC, AD. BC, BD. BC, CD. Same AB edge is there, BC is there, AC is there, AD is there, CD is there. Here also same means one diagram can be drawn more than one. There can be a there can be a more than one diagram for the same graph here. Clear? Suppose if the graph has a number of finite number of edges, is there, then it is called finite graph. If the graph contains finite number of edges, then it is called a finite graph. Clear? Finite number of vertices as well as a finite number of edges. Then it is called a finite graph. If a graph contains finite number of edges and finite number of vertices, then it is called a finite graph. Otherwise, it is called infinite graph. So, infinite graph, and we also will mean only a finite graph here. We study almost all the finite graphs only in the chapter. So, now I am moving to the next topic, that is order and size. Order means number of vertices that should be finite. Because we are studying here only the finite graph. So order means number of vertices, and size means number of edges. We can also say that cardinality of, suppose G equal to V comma E is your graph. Cardinality of V means, this is called cardinality of V, is called a order. Cardinality of V. Similarly, cardinality of E, this is a cardinality of E, is called size. Here the order and size can also be indicated by N and M. N is the order and M is the size. Then we called N comma M is a graph. A graph of order N and a size M is called N comma M graph. A graph of order N and a size M is called N comma M graph here. Here one is clear that a graph with a n vertices and zero edges, or simply a null graph with n vertices is a n comma zero graph, because there is a number of edges will be zero. So you can denote it by n comma zero graph. So, next I am taking, suppose G is a graph, then we can denote a vertices either by the capital letter A, B, C, D, and also as a V1, small letter V1, V2, V3, so on. So, as we are convenient, we can consider the vertices here, and the edges of the graph is denoted by E1, E2, E3, so on here. If VI and VJ are the denote the two vertices of a G, and if EK denotes the edge which joining the vertices VI and VJ, like this, VI and VJ. And this edge is indicated by EK. And this is symbolically written as EK equal to VI comma VJ. Or simply you can write it as VI VJ. Yeah? Suppose we denote that this is called, then the vertices VI and VJ called. Then these vertices are called end vertices. Then these vertices are called end vertices here. Suppose, as we have studied in the previous, consider a graph A, B, C, D. Here see that I am giving a denote for edge AB equal to E1. Then we say that A and B are the end vertices of the E1. And I will denote BC equal to E2. Then B and C are called the end vertices of E2. If I denote the edge CD equal to E3, then the vertices CD are called end vertices of E3. Similarly, AD equal to E4 and AC equal to E5 and so on. So then that is called the end vertices of the edges. So now consider a graph here. I am considering one graph here. V1, V2, V3, V4. I am joining the edges V1, V2, V1, V4. V1, V3, V2, V4, V1, V4, V3. Call this one as E4, E1, E2, E3, E5, E6. See here, V1, V2, V3, V4 are the V1, V2, V3, V4 are the vertices. E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6 are the edges. Here, the edges E2 and E3 are intersect each other. Seems like intersect each other. They are seems like intersecting each other. We can also join a V1 like this also. We can draw the V3. But in this diagram, I am taking like this. But this is not an vertices here. It is simply a point of intersection. It is not a vertices or vertex. Clear it is? It may be intersect or it not may be. But it is not a vertex here. And now observe. E1 has a edge V1, V2. E1 has a vertices V1, V2. Edge E2 is equal to V1, V3. Edge E3 equal to V4, V2. See here, all the E1, E2, E3 have a different end vertices. But see the graph, see the edges E5 and E6. Both E5 and E6 have a same end vertices. Therefore, E5 and E6 are called the parallel edges. Parallel edges means if the two edges have same end vertices, then it is called parallel edges. If in a graph two edges have the same end vertices, then it is called parallel edges. Parallel edges means parallel edges in a graph. If two edges have same end vertices, then it is called parallel edges. Suppose if more than two edges have the same end vertices, then it is called multiple edges. Then those edges will be called a multiple edges. See the next topic, that is simple graph. And one more thing here. See the edge E4 here. Edge E4 have the same E4 have V3, V3 only. means end vertices are same here. Here the end vertices V1 and V2, but in the edge E4, V3 is have the same end vertices. Then it is called a loop. E4 has the same vertex V3 as both of its end vertices will be same. Therefore, it is called a loop. In a graph, there is an edge with a same end vertices, with its both of its end vertices are same, then it is called a loop. So next I am moving to the simple graph. Simple graph means a graph which does not contain loops and multiple edges is called simple graph. A graph which does not contain a loop and multiple edges, then it is called a simple graph. A graph which does not contain a loop is called loop free graph. And a graph contain multiple edges but no loops is called multigraph. And a graph which contain multiple edges or loops or both, or both multiples and loops, then it is called a general graph. A graph which does not contain a loop and multiple edges is called a simple graph. A graph which does not contain a loop is called a loop-free graph. A graph which contain multiple edges but not a loops is called a multigraph. A graph which contain multiple edges or loops or both is called a general graph. Clear here? And we can denote a simple graph like this. A, B, C, D. There is no loops here. Clear? And this is called multigraph with free from loops. There is no loops. And this graph is called general graph, which contain multiple edges and also the loops, then is called a general loop. And this is may also called a general graph also. This is also called general graph. If there is no loop, then also we can call this as a general graph, also multiple graph, multigraph. But this can compulsory, we can say that general graph only. We cannot say that this is a multigraph because there is a loop in the at a vertex D. Clear it is? In some situations what happened, if we not assign any names to the vertices like this. We didn't assign the name to the vertices here. This one is a 1 vertex, 2, 3. Here the 3 vertices will be there. But if we not assign a names to the vertices, such a graph will be called unlabeled graphs. Unlabeled graphs. If we assign the name to the vertices, then it is called labeled graphs. Labeled graph. Clear it is? Like this. A, B, C. It is called a labeled graph because we assigned a name to the vertices here. If we not assign the name to the vertices, then it is called unlabeled graph. Now I am moving to the topic, that is incidence. Incidence means, suppose V is a vertex of the graph G and is an end vertex of the edge E. Suppose E is the edge having the end vertex V, then we call E is incident. E is incident on the vertex V. E is incident on the vertex V. Suppose V is a vertex of a graph G and it is an end vertex of an edge E of the graph G, then we say that edge E is incident on the vertex V. Since every edge has a two end vertices, we know that. Suppose A V1 V2 and this is an edge E1. Then E1 has an end vertices V1 V2. So that every edge has two end vertices. So every edge is incident on two vertices. Every edge is incident on two vertices. Every edge is incident on two vertices. The two end vertices, suppose the two end vertices are coincident. Two end vertices are coincident means like this. This is an E1 suppose. In the edge E1, the two end vertices are coincident means both are equal. Then it is loop. If two end vertices are coincident, then if the edge is loop. And we are saying that, suppose consider an example. A, B, C, D, E1, E2 and E3. The two non-parallel edges, parallel means like this or like this, clear? If two non-parallel edges are said to be adjacent edges, non-parallel edges are said to be adjacent edges if they are incident on a common vertex means see here the edge E1 and E2. E1 have an end vertex AB. E2 is also have an end vertex BC. Means B is a common vertex for both E1 and E2. Therefore, E1 and E2 are called the parallel edges. Similarly, E2 and E3. E2 and E3 have a common end vertex C. Therefore, these are called parallel edges. Similarly, two vertices are said to be adjacent vertices are also called the neighbors. if there is an edge joining them, means A and B are called the neighbors if there is an edge between the vertices AB. See here, A and D are not called the neighbors because there is no edge between A and B. Similarly, between A and C, there is no edge between A and C. Therefore, these are not called the neighbors. Similarly, B and C is called the neighbor because there is an edge between B and C. But there is no edge between B and C. Therefore, B and D are called not a neighbors here. Therefore, adjacent vertices in this graph. Adjacent vertices are A and B is the adjacent vertices, B and C are the adjacent vertices, C and D are the adjacent vertices. Similarly, adjacent edges, E1 and E2 are the adjacent edges, E2 and E3 are the adjacent edges in this graph. Clear it is?